Hey everyone, welcome to 99.6 The Howl episode 10 for the uninitiated. This is an unedited YouTube video discussing everything Arizona Coyotes, back-to-back games, top two teams in the league. Well, Washington used to be, they're kind of struggling this season, but back-to-back wins for the Coyotes, obviously not. But they played really well against the Caps. They lost 3-2 in overtime. Wedgwood gained the start in that one. Coyotes up early, 2-0. Capos came back. Coyotes gave them about 6 power play opportunities. And you don't do that when you got Ovechkin, Kuznetsov, Backstrom, Oshie, Carlson on the opposing team. You just can't give them that many power plays. Capos tied up 2-2. Overtime, you know, you can't. They had Ekman, Larson, Perlini, and Dvorak out there with the aforementioned star players of the league. Think Oshie wrapped that one up, scoring in overtime. But it was a deserving point for the Coyotes. They played well enough in the game to get a point, even win the game. Wedgwood played solid. Defense were solid. A lot of offense, and it was a good game. Next night, which was last night against Pittsburgh, much different story. They go down early, 2-0, couple quick goals by Pittsburgh, catching Ranta sleeping, and the team sleeping. It was 2-0 for pretty much the whole game until the third period, where Tobias Reeder finally scores his first goal in about 12 games. Great to see him get on the score sheet. So it was 2-1. Coyotes were battling in the third, but penalty trouble. They took about 7 penalties. And finally, Pittsburgh's going to score, just like the Caps. When you have Crosby, Malkin, Kessel, Letang, you're not going to keep them off the score sheet on 7 power plays. So finally, on their last power play, Pittsburgh scores, makes it 3-1. And from there on, the Coyotes were pretty much deflated. Ranta kept them in the game much longer than they should have been. I mean, any other goalie in net, this game would have been a blowout. 6-0, 5-1, whatever. Just Ranta played unbelievable. Sure, the first goal was pretty weak. But, you know, what are you going to do? Not Ranta's fault at all. He played awesome. He was up to the task. The Achilles heel of the Coyotes these past two games were penalties. And against Pittsburgh, a lot of odd man rushes. I mean, reminiscent of Buffalo game last week, where Buffalo scored on 4 odd man rushes. Last night, just 2-on-1s, way too many 2-on-1s against the Pittsburgh Penguins of all teams. With their speed and skill, you just can't let that happen. I think the defense is really shaky this season, and it's showing. It used to be the goaltending that was the issue. Now that we shored up that problem, the defense is really showing in their lack of skill and lack of ability to make plays under pressure. Think Kanadin and Shen, that needs to go. Something needs to happen. Mermis is playing steady. He doesn't really make many mistakes. So I hope when Jarmerson comes back, whenever that is, Mermis can stay in the lineup as a third pairing D-man and push Kanadin and Shen to the press box or even on waivers. I mean, I'm sorry, but Kanadin gets a high-sticking penalty late in the third. The puck isn't even near the other Pittsburgh Penguin player, and the ice sticks him in front of the net, just a lazy penalty. You got to keep your stick on the ice. I don't know why it sticks in the air at all when you're battling in front of the net and the pucks. There's no threat. There's no offensive threat. And you're high-sticking the opposing player. It was really unfortunate. And obviously they scored on that penalty. But it's kind of the same old story lately. The Coyotes are playing good for a couple minutes, maybe a period, 2 periods. But it's like little 2 to 5 minute chunks that they're just folding under pressure. And thankfully now we have Ranta to, you know, keep the wave at bay. whereas earlier in the season we had Domingue and Hill, which they couldn't handle the waves. So hopefully we get going here. It was a back-to-back, so you can't really blame them for the Pittsburgh game. I mean, Pittsburgh on their back-to-backs get blown out. I think it was three times already this season they've been blown out on their back-to-backs. So losing 3-1 on a back-to-back against Washington and Pittsburgh, I'll take it. You know, we'll take that all day. But the Coyotes need to get going. They got to string some wins together. They can't do this win a game, feel good, and then lose the next one. They gotta keep at it. We need Johansson back. We haven't had a full team lineup. I think we had one game of a full roster. One game of just Shaika's vision of this team. I think it was the Vegas game in Arizona. But yeah, can't have these defensive breakdowns. We got St. Louis Thursday and Winnipeg Saturday. Winnipeg will be a home game for the Coyotes. A lot of Eastern road trips to start the season, so maybe it's good to gain these losses out of the way to teams not even in their conference. Like I mentioned in another video, haven't even begun to face Pacific Division teams. So they got to get out of this funk and grab some points against their divisional rivals. That's it for me. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your support.